Once an AGM gets shorter, it means there's something going on which is correct. Because if not, then there will be discussions at the AGM. I'm quite pleased with that as what is happening in our organization. Every organization will have challenges at certain points in time. What is key is how you deal with those challenges. I'm quite happy.
I thought that Cricket South Africa have done extremely well on various fronts. Literally, they've shed the pebble in the shoe. And if you look back, they have taken resolutions on various aspects, from governance up to funding, to everything, to appointments and where they spend the resources. And one can only say this much, as from a government perspective, we can compliment them and encourage them to keep on raising the bar. More importantly was, I referred again to the successful launch of the T20 League, which we think is very exciting. If you look at the opportunities created for our players, the stream from the hubs that we think must be unearthed to feed the Protea squad, we really pause and we say, well done, thumbs up, we're fully behind you. And that also addresses one of the needs of government, and it addresses a priority of government, namely that of tourism, job creation, and alleviation of poverty. More importantly, you look at the Cricket Women's World Cup. We've done very well. We've seen some of our women cricketers being taken up now in two leagues in Australia and in London. It augurs well for the female cricketers and female sport in this country, and we compliment them for that. But equally, we also recognized this morning that, you know, we have in our Protea men's team players of international standard, ranking amongst the best in the ICC rankings, and we pay tribute to them.
The year that we are currently emerging from, the key success story has been the ability of CSA to drive through its transformation agenda, the ability of CSA to also look at improving the venues that we have, the amount of money that we have invested in the stadiums, and also the fact that we are starting and preparing for the T20 Global League, and there is a new kid on the block, and it's going to succeed because we have invested a lot of money and effort in it.
We have the smallest budget, and we have to do the most. We stretch it. And we are so excited and taken up with the owners, the foreign owners, the T20 leagues that came in and said, we are putting $25,000 per hub to develop and unearth the talent there, which will eventually feed in to the Protea squad. We from our side said, over and above the annual grant to cricket, we are adding another R1 million from government side. And I this morning said to the AGM, and I've requested them to convey the message to the foreign owners and so on, to say, come on, match what government has done. Your $25,000 step it up to R1 million so that we can see quicker access for people that don't have the access at the moment.
I think what we're doing is right. That the fact that people outside see it and comment on it, it should give us impetus to go on and do more. But also we should not be complacent and think that we have arrived, we have not arrived. There's still a lot of challenges. There's a long road ahead. What we need to do is to ensure that what we have done right, we consolidate, and then we go on to achieve more.
Thank you for good governance. Thank you for doing sterling work and for having adopted the sport, National Sport and Recreation Plan, the Transformation Charter, and thank you for having shared the pebbles that caused the trouble.